Sometimes the smallest of spaces have the most potential. Hey there, hi, welcome to the channel. I am Garrett, and in this video, we're talking all about small bathrooms, teeny tiny spaces, and what you can do with them, some trends, some ideas to incorporate, and things that will change your space. So many of you commented that you loved my best and worst bathroom trends of 2022 video, but you have small spaces and don't know what to do. I'm sharing with you some of the best trends and ideas to incorporate into those spaces to make them work for you. So let's get into the video. The first of the bathroom trends that I actually think is really amazing for small bathrooms is contrasting marble. Now, a lot of people have a lot of opinions on these bold marble choices and these slab cut stones used in bathrooms, but in a smaller space, these can be really bold and really impactful. The big trend is contrasting. So we're using two different types of marble, but what's really interesting about this and what I like is we're using the inverse colors. So a black and white marble that's predominantly white with black veins on the walls might have a black marble with white veins on the floor. This is a really interesting way to break up the space, to create a little bit of visual interest, some contrast happening in a space. This is a fun option that I actually really like. I think it's unique, I think it's interesting, and I think it's just something different. I feel like we're doing a lot of the same thing where everything is just white and then we have some black metal hardware, like it's just boring. I think this is an interesting way to do a black and white color scheme or any color scheme for that matter, because there's a lot of unique marble options. You could do something like a white with a green vein marble on a wall and then a green floor. How sumptuous would that be? I think there's a lot of good options and ideas to do with this and incorporate into a space. You can get very creative in a small space because those are the ones that can really take the most and the most impactful design. I think this is beautiful and something worth considering. Something I always think is important to consider in a smaller bathroom is what you're doing in terms of a color scheme. Something like a powder room, you can have a really bold wallpaper, a bold tile, or something like that. But that's not what this video is about. This is about main bathrooms, and we're talking about color schemes in these spaces you are going to actually use every day. And maybe you live in an older home that has smaller bathrooms, or maybe your home only has one bathroom. Maybe you have a big primary bathroom, but then the secondary bathrooms in your house are a little smaller. Using a tighter color scheme in those spaces will actually make them feel a little bit brighter, a little more open. What I mean by using a tight color scheme is sticking to a specific color scheme, only a few colors, and not varying from that too much. Whether that's black and white, or you want to go bold and vibrant with like green and pink and white or something like that, you can do that and have a lot of fun with it, but stick to it very closely. Don't vary too much from those tones. Don't have it in too many places or ways, because it will make a space feel full, a little bit cluttered, and a little bit claustrophobic. We want these smaller spaces to feel bright and feel open. You do a color scheme that you like because we want your personality in the space, but be mindful of how impactful that is going to be in a space you use every day. A powder room that plays amazingly because you don't necessarily use it every day. You're not in there for long periods of time. But your main bathroom, you might actually be. You don't want to have it be, you know, completely dark or cavernous because you're getting ready in that space. You want to have a bright and fresh light color scheme that will make the space feel open and bright, but you want to stick specifically to that color scheme. The next idea I have for you in a small bathroom is actually to enhance the verticality of the space. What that means is take advantage of the ceiling height. You're gonna have more height than you probably do floor space. Drawing the eye up will distract from the fact that there's maybe not a lot of floor space. This is a great way to decorate, to incorporate some accessories and some color into a space. You could do something like paint your ceiling in contrasting color or add a contrasting tile to your ceiling. These are really fun options, but you can also do this through maybe having a floor-to-ceiling gallery wall or taking that space above the toilet and hanging artwork all the way up to the ceiling. So maybe not to the floor, but to the toilet, whatever. There's a lot of fun options you have in this realm of design by increasing the height of the space. One trick I love to use is to actually hang blinds to the ceiling. So even if maybe they cover a lot of the wall and they stop at the top of a window, you're enhancing the space, you're bringing the eye up, even though you're using a necessity, an item that's necessary to the space, because we all like to have a little bit of privacy in our bathrooms, even if they are smaller spaces. By enhancing the verticality, you bring the eye up away from a smaller space, making it feel more open and more airy. While we're on the topic of bathrooms, be sure you head over and check out my bathroom playlist, as well as some of the playlists for other areas in your home. And I know that everyone asks you, but take a moment and hit that subscribe button, because 2022 is going to be an epic year and we have some incredible videos coming your way. Now, back to the video. The next big trend for bathrooms I'm seeing that I have mixed feelings about, as you all know, are console vanities and pedestal vanities. The big question is, where is your stuff? And these don't have any of that storage space. A powder room, I love them, they're gorgeous, they're sumptuous, please put them in. But for a main bathroom, there's just not enough storage, especially if it's the main bathroom in your house. If you have multiple people using that bathroom, you wanna have more storage. If you are going to opt for these, look for something that is going to add storage in another way. They only have kind of one shelf and a towel bar. This is good if you don't have a lot of stuff or you have storage somewhere else, so look at adding some in another way. If you have one of these that doesn't have a shelf, find a small cabinet that will slide into it, or maybe put your hamper there. There's a lot of interesting ideas you can take advantage of with these. I personally would not add one into a new bathroom, but if you already have one, take advantage of it, value what you have, and make it work for you and the space. Now, if you have a pedestal sink, it's an entirely different situation. A pedestal sink doesn't have storage at all, but there are cabinets I'm sure you all are aware of that are made to go under these sinks. That can add some storage in a really great way. A lot of those really retro, vintage bathrooms that are these pastel colors have these pedestal sinks, and they're beautiful and worth saving, but you can add storage in a different way. Another great alternative to add storage is with recessed storage. This can be a medicine cabinet, a small cabinet or bookshelf, something like that that goes into the wall. They need to be professionally installed, but you get storage without sacrificing floor space. I love these. I think they're beautiful. Medicine cabinets can be lit inside on the glass fronts of them. They can have outlets in them, meaning you can take all of those ugly things, which we actually talked about in my ugly home essentials and how to elevate them video. You can take them and tuck them all away. Really great, effective use of space. For me, I'm an out of sight, out of mind person. So I like the alternative to this, which is an open cabinet. You can display your beautiful things, make them aesthetic, and they're right there where you can see them. These are really good options for adding storage to a space that doesn't have a lot of floor space, room, you can't add a cabinet, or you don't have a vanity. There's also really cool ideas like these cabinets that can be built into walls for your little plunger, your scrubby brush, you don't have to look at them and see them. Those are alternative options that can be really, really great. Another idea, if you have a linen closet, if you have a closet just outside your bathroom, get some storage baskets, put your overflow, your backstock items into those, and move them out of the bathroom. That way they're close and convenient, but you don't have them cluttering a space because you may not have the storage for those items. Something else I love as an alternative to the medicine cabinet is the oversized mirror. Right now we see a lot of people using vintage or antique mirrors in a space, mirrors that you'll find at a store and hanging them up. I love this and I think it's beautiful. But if you like to have that kind of plate or flat mirror that's really big and oversized, something I really love that one of my favorite hotels in the world does is they take a mirror and a plate mirror, they'll affix it to the wall. It has a beveled edge on it, so you get a lot of beautiful detail, and then they have a stone surround. And it's maybe made with oversized tiles or slab cut stone, depends on which suite you're in. Hey, love that for us. But this is a really great way to get a very polished and finished look. If you already have the oversized plate mirror, consider adding a frame onto it. These can be affixed with glue, they don't have to be nailed in, and you're not gonna damage the mirror with them. A really great way to upgrade and elevate what you have without having to take anything away. You're just adding something extra. Love that. Another great storage idea for these smaller bathrooms are floating shelves. A lot of times I see bathrooms that have kind of cabinets affixed to the wall. I don't like anything that projects that much that you can kind of see the side of. It creates bulk. It immediately says to me like, farmhouse or kitschy. If that's your style, I love that and definitely go for it. But if you're looking for something that's a little more streamlined, consider some floating shelves. There are plenty of options. You can have painted shelves, you can have oak shelves. I really like a glass shelf for a bathroom, even though, yes, you will see a little bit of dust and the glass shelves probably have to be cleaned a little bit more often. They are really beautiful and give you that hotel finish and look. Like I was saying, my favorite hotel in the world, they have the mirrors and they also will add in these shelves because it just enhances the storage space. It gives you a little bit of extra room for your things. You can see them. And once again, I'm an out of sight, out of mind type of person. If I can't see it, I won't use it. I like to have my things where I can see them, but I like for them to be tucked away. That way they're not cluttering up my countertop. This is also a really great option to get you that and get you that extra storage space. There's a lot of trends out there that we see in larger bathrooms, but can be scaled down or used in smaller spaces as well that can be just as effective, if not better, than what we're already doing. And one of my favorite is the side sconce. We used to see a lot of bathrooms that would have kind of the over the mirror sconce fixture that had multiple bulbs. These are cool if you have them, take advantage of them. There are a lot of beautiful options you can replace these with if you're looking to upgrade them. But what is really in right now, very popular, and will add a little bit of a classic touch or feeling to your bathroom are the side sconces. Either side of a mirror, these are beautiful, they're classic and timeless, gorgeous, and you have a lot of options. You could do something very modern or contemporary, you can do something very traditional, or you can mix and match within a space. A modern space, add a little bit more of a classic element or a traditional style fixture. In a more traditional space, add something unexpected. Go for something modern or something that's maybe art deco. These sconces, these side sconces, will upgrade and elevate a space and make it feel so fresh and current without having to really do much work. These are very interesting and unique, and one example of a trend for a large bathroom that you can incorporate into a smaller space. We also love these for a powder room because they're very, very elegant and elevated. They look and feel luxurious because they have a commercial styling to them, like you would see in a hotel or a restaurant bathroom. And that's always something unique and interesting to add to a residential space. Be sure to check out some small bathroom essentials like these light fixtures linked in my Amazon store in the description box down below. Well, there you have it, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to let me know in the comment section down below. I want to hear from you, especially those of my subscribers who have these small bathroom spaces and have got creative with storage solutions. Be sure to share with us and let us know in the comment section. And while you're at it, give this video a like, and if you're not already, hit the subscribe button. And I know that you know someone that has a teeny tiny little itty bitty baby bathroom that maybe could use a little bit of storage help because it's the only bathroom in their house. When you go over, that's their guest bathroom and it's got stuff I can't handle it. Share this video with them because friends help friends. And I will see you in the next one.